Welcome to Maths by SAZ. This is my fifth lesson of D2, chapter number 4, exercise 4D, factorization by grouping. In this lesson, I will complete question number 5, intermediate level, that says factorize each of the following completely. With this, we will be able to complete and finish chapter 4. I hope these all efforts will be helpful for my students in this crucial period of COVID-19. There are some basic terms that we have to understand, that what is factorization, what is factorization by grouping, factorization by extracting common factor. For this lesson, you should have the command of the tables and mathematics skills, and you have to integrate the lesson with the previous lessons, because for the foundation of mathematics, it's really necessary to integrate your previous concepts with the new concepts. Let's move to the question. The first part of the question is 2xy minus 8x plus 12 minus 3y. It's always good to rewrite the question. I've written the question for you people. As the topic is factorization by grouping, so after writing the question, you have to see that from these four terms, which two terms can be put in one group. If you look at 2xy minus 8x, we can see that here from the numbers 2 and 8, 2 is the common factor. We can extract that out. And from the letters, x is the common letter. So I hope this is the suitable choice. We can make one group from these two terms. So what I will be doing, I'll be putting them in one group. And then from 12 and 3y, table of 12 can come in 3. 3 is suitable for 12 for 4 times. So you can put, or you can make another group from these two terms. Now after making the groups, you have to see that what number or letter is common in each group. From 2xy minus 8x, from the numbers, 2 is the common factor, and from the letters x. So after pulling out 2x, from the first place I will left with y, then I have to copy the sign as it is. 2 is how many times suitable for 8? 4. Y minus 4, because x is already out. Coming to the second part of the question, see 3 and 12, what can be extracted out? That is 3. And if I'm extracting 3 out from 12, I will left with 4 minus y. Now see that the first part is having y positive and 4 negative, but the second part is having 4 positive and y negative. We have to rearrange the second group and we have to make the terms same in the second group. So what I will be doing, I have to try to make this y positive. So what we will be doing, we will be multiplying. Let me finish this step. Focus on this step. To make y positive and 4 negative, I have to multiply and divide this whole factor by 3, minus sign. When I will be multiplying, 1 minus sign will remain over here. And when I will be dividing that with the second group, this will rearrange, this will change the sign of the term. So now I have the same groups at first place and the second place. Extract the common group out. Common group is y minus 4 into 2x minus 3. I hope this is clear to you. This is really important step to understand. You have to focus on this step. Moving to the next question. The next question is 5xy minus 25x square plus 50x minus 10y. Again, rewrite the question and think about which two terms can be put in one group. If we look at 5xy and 25x square, 5 can be extracted as a common factor, and from letter x is the common factor. Coming to the second part, we can see that 50x minus 10y, so what can be common factor here? 10 can be common factor, so keep them in the bracket. Now see what can be taken as a common factor out from the numbers 5 and from the letters x. From the first place, from 5xy, I've extracted 5 out. I will left with y minus 5x. Y minus 5x. Coming to the second part, from 10 and 50, I have to pull out. I have to extract 10 out. And I will left with 5x minus y. Again, look at this step, that in the first part, y is positive. But here in the second part, y is negative. So I have to rearrange this bracket. And what I will be doing, that I will be multiplying and dividing this term by minus sign. So my expression will take the form 5x into y minus 5x minus 10. I'm multiplying and dividing here by minus sign. One minus sign will change the sign outside, and one minus sign will be applied over here, and it will be written in the form y minus 5x. Now, this y minus 5x is the common group, common factor. Extract it out, pull it out. 5x minus 10 and close the bracket, and y minus 5x. Okay, we have to give our answer in most simplified form. If we look at 5x minus 10, we can extract 5 common from here. So finally, what we have to do is, I will take out 5 here, x minus 2 into y minus 5x. I hope the question is clear to you. Let's move to the next question. Next question is x square y square minus 5x square y minus 5x y square plus x y cube. Rewrite the question, sorry. And after writing the question, you have to make the groups of like terms, like x square y square minus 5x square y can be taken in one group, and I can make the groups of these two terms. Okay, now see what can be taken as a common factor, x square, and from y and y square I can take y out, and from first place I will be left with y minus 5. Then from the second part, what can be taken as a common factor, x. Okay, I've not written the sign here, I'm discussing about that, x and y square. Now see, when I've extracted x and y square, I will left with minus 5 and plus here x and y square is out and y. Now see what sign I have to mark here, because I'm keeping my sign of 5 as it is and sign of y as it is. So here I have to mark positive sign. This is again an important step to understand. Now see, y minus 5 and minus 5 plus y, we do not need to make any changes in these brackets. We just have to rearrange the terms and we will get the answer. So what we will be doing, that we will write it y minus y plus x y square into y minus 5. Now this y minus 5 is the common group. Extract it out, pull it out, and what we will be doing, y minus 5 into x square y plus x y square. Again, finally see that in this group we can have x y as a common factor. So I have to extract that x y as a common factor out, y minus 5, and when I've extracted from x square y x y out, I will write x plus y. I hope this question is clear to you. These are easy questions, really important questions for CIE exam as well. Moving to the last part of the question, last part is kx plus hy minus hx minus ky. Okay, rewrite the question and quickly make the groups of like and suitable terms. Okay, from the first group we can see that, no, we cannot make, we have to rearrange the terms, sorry. So what we can do is that we can write kx minus hx plus hy minus ky. You need to rearrange sometime. Now see that from the first two terms I can extract x out and I will left with k minus h and plus y into h minus k. Again see, this is k minus h and this is h minus k. I have to rearrange this bracket. So what I will be doing, k minus h, I will multiply and divide the second term by minus sign and my expression will take the form k minus h. Now extract k minus h out and x minus y. I hope you are clear about this question. For next difficulty level, please catch me in the next class. Watch, like and share my lessons and subscribe the channel and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.